welcome. My name is Art Channel. My name is Hilkjan Wiersma. And today I am not gonna talk about this painting yet. This is quite a big painting. It is 80 by 100 centimeters. But I'm still working on this one. As you can see, I have a lot of fur to do here. But I already did the background. But because I am very busy with my job and it is very warm here in the Netherlands, it's unusual this high temperature for us, so it is very warm in my studio, so I'm not painting that much at the moment, but I will continue that as soon as possible as the weather and when the temperature in the studio is a little bit lower, and because it's like I said, very warm here now. But this one will be up in 2 or 3 weeks, I think. But I hope as soon as possible I can upload it. But like I said, I still have quite some work to do on this painting. So therefore, I like to talk more about this painting. I will have a picture now from this Janet painting that I did in 2015. And back then I didn't do my voiceover, so I thought it would be nice to do a voiceover now. And I already wanted to do that with the older tutorials I have on my channel, with music. I will eventually put in a voiceover, because I think I can explain quite some nice things about the painting and go more talk about the techniques I use. So therefore I like to once in a while take a older video and put a voiceover into a video for the tutorial. And so therefore, yeah, that is what we're gonna do for today, and I hope you will enjoy this. And apparently I didn't have all the footage anymore, but basically you did not miss that much, because I just laid in a quite simple background with a lot of blue and a bit of differences in dark blue and lighter blue. And then I drew out my genet, and now I'm filling in the feathers and I'm just building up. And in this stage I'm using acrylic paint. I will end up using oil paint, but I'm now using acrylic paint just to layer in my first make my first layers of feathers and colors. And later on I will glaze over that with my oil paints. And a little correction, I did this painting in 2016 and not in 2015, like I said in the intro. But it doesn't matter that much, but it's a little bit newer than I thought it was. And what you see me doing here is just, like I said, building up those feathers. And the hard part of this was, for me this time, was that the differences between the lighter and the darker colors of the feathers wasn't that big. And I wanted to copy that, because I want to give it a realistic look, of course. But therefore I kept building up and painting in those feathers, because I lost too many lines, and I was just looking for the nice transition of the darks and the lights, and especially on those feathers of his body. And those feathers are white, but not actually white, so therefore I'm using a lot of blue. And like I said, I was building up, and I did it quite slowly, so I didn't lose my texture of the feathers too quickly. And also therefore I liked to use later on in the painting my oil paint, so I could lay down a nice layer with the acrylics with the texture of the feathers, and then glaze over with my oils to correct the colors. So I'm a bit off of the colors right now, but that doesn't matter that much. And now I'm painting in the rocks, and I will have a photo of the original photo of this genet. Here it is, and it is made by Jan Bos, and he allowed me to use his photo. And now you can see that I'm trying to copy the texture of the rocks. I'm not as much focused on the colors yet, but just the texture. And not texture that you can feel on the canvas, but texture you can see on the canvas, or see in the photo on this at this moment. But I try to lay in those different shapes and different directions and different colors, and by that I mean especially the lights and the darks. And of course I'm using different brown tones, but like I said, I'm not focused on the actual colors right now. I will glaze over them, and that will come on later. But you now have a little idea what I'm watching while I am painting how the reference photo look for this painting, and just try to copy what I see. And the same thing is does apply here when I'm painting in feathers or basically everything. I'm just trying to copy what I see, and it sounds very easy, but I know it's very hard, especially in the beginning, but you will get used to it. The more you practice, the easier it will get. And also which I found quite a nice thing was that I noticed when while I was starting painting that after I think about a half a year, I did notice more details than in the beginning. Those details, we have the tendency not to see them all, and we may think we see them all, but in the beginning it's very hard. But the more you practice, the more details you will see, and the better your paintings will get. Especially when you do photorealism, you need that details, but it will come. So don't be afraid of that. You will get it if you are practicing. And I try to practice as many as I can. And for now, for this month, there's a little exception to that. But just try to practice, and don't forget, and that's the most important thing, just have fun with your paintings. Because if you have fun, you learn much more and much better. And here I'm starting in the with the oil paints, and I'm just glazing over. I now have a nice texture on my canvas, and now I only have to focus on the colors and maybe a few details, but not that much. So now I'm layering in, and I darkened up the background a bit more, so it the genet and the light portions on the genet around his head and a few light portions on his wings will stand out even more. And I really like that contrast. And in a minute you will see my the photo of the painting, and you may see in the corners I have some bumps going on. That is because I did use a cheap canvas. So be aware, if you're using cheap canvases, this can happen to you, and now I cannot sell this painting. But I liked it even, so therefore it will stay in my own collection, but be aware of that. So that was my Janet painting I did, like I said, a few years ago. If you want to know more about this painting, you can find it on my website. And also, if you like, you can follow me on Instagram, Facebook, and like I said, on my own website. If you like this tutorial, please give it a thumbs up. And of course, I would really appreciate it when you subscribe to my channel. Because, like I said earlier in other tutorials, I really see it as a compliment for my work. And I really like enjoying making these videos, this tutorial. So, therefore, please subscribe to my channel. And for now, I'd like to thank you for watching. And I hope to see you at one of my next tutorials. Bye-bye.